Hello everyone, you all know that Mumbai is getting heavy rainfall these days, but still at the end of the month of June, there is 33% deficit in the rainfall, which is the highest in 5 years. The Indian Meteorological Department said that El Nino, though weak this year, could also have played a role in the below normal rainfall in the month of June. So, in today's lecture, let us understand what is El Nino, how it impacts the Indian economy, and what role it plays in the world. El Nino in Spanish means a little child. The basic definition of El Nino is that abnormal weather conditions in the central equatorial Pacific Ocean as well as the eastern Pacific Ocean. Rise in temperature of about 0.5 to 1 degree Celsius in the Pacific Ocean results in El Nino condition. This rise in temperature affects the trade winds in the Pacific Ocean as well as in the Indian Ocean. This affects the monsoon of India, Southeast India, Southeast Asian countries, and Australia and Africa. Now, we know that global weather conditions are mainly decided by oceanic currents and wind circulations, which mainly depend on the temperature of the oceans. Now, let us understand what is El Nino. When there is prediction of normal monsoon in the Indian continent, that is, when there is no El Nino, what happens? Let us understand in great detail. So, on the eastern coast of South America, here this country is Peru, and on the coastline of Peru, there lies a strong oceanic current, also known as Peruvian current or Humboldt current. The economies of the Peru and Ecuador, which is this country, which is situated almost at 0 degree latitude, that is the equator, and that is why the country is named as Ecuador. The economy of Ecuador and Peru depends upon this strong oceanic current. Why? Because this strong cold current on the west coast of South America is an upwelling current which brings a lot of nutrients, and the economy of Peru and Ecuador mainly depends on fishing, and since this current is upwelling current, it brings a lot of fishes to the coastline of the Peru and Ecuador. Due to high cold current, there is a high pressure zone near this region. And this high pressure zone is in the eastern equatorial Pacific Ocean. On the other hand, since the earth is round in shape, or more probably spherical, on the coastline of the Australian, there is a warm current. And since the earth is like spherical, so beside South America comes the Australia. And so there, since the at the coastline of Australia there is a warm current. Warm current means warmer winds and low pressure zone. And so at the coastline of South America there is cold current and high pressure zone. And on the other hand, at the coastline of Australia there is warmer current, which means low pressure. So this creates a pressure gradient, and the strong, and we all know that the high pressure winds move towards low pressure. So these strong trade winds from eastern Pacific Ocean move towards the western Pacific Ocean near the coastline of Australia. These trade winds, while moving from this eastern Pacific to western Pacific, pick up moisture from the Pacific Ocean and cause rainfall to Australian continent. It causes rainfall to Australia. Now these trade winds, again moving towards the western Pacific Ocean, pick moisture from warmer winds and cause rainfall to Australia. These trade winds then travel towards the Indian Ocean, which is this region. This region is the Indian Ocean. These trade winds, while moving towards the Indian Ocean, pick up more moisture from the Indian Ocean. Since the subcontinent of India is heated up because of the extreme summer season in the country, it is even low pressure. Low pressure region of the Indian Ocean, but the pressure in the Indian subcontinent is still lower than that in the Indian Ocean. So the trade winds continue to pick up moisture from the warm waters. Initially the direction is from northeast, it is northeast, and after crossing the equator it changes to southwest due to Coriolis effect. By this time the low pressure zone in India near the Tibetan Plateau, as there is a low pressure zone in India, as entire subcontinent is heated up, so pressure is low. So since the pressure is low, it attracts the high pressure winds from the Indian Ocean, and which brings the rainfall to the Indian subcontinent. That is often called a southwest monsoon. So we know, we conclude that ability of southwest winds to take up moisture and deliver rainfall in the Indian subcontinent is directly proportional to the conditions in the Pacific Ocean near the coastline of the Peru and Ecuador. So this was the phenomena when there was no El Nino condition. Now, during El Nino movement, that is, there is an increase in temperature in the central equatorial Pacific Ocean and the eastern equatorial Pacific Ocean. So this results in warm water in the central equatorial Pacific Ocean and eastern equatorial Pacific Ocean. So the Peruvian cold currents are subsided, and the pressure near the coastline of the South America decreases rapidly. Now we also know that near the Australia and Indonesia there is warm water, there is warm current, and the winds are also hot. So there is high pressure on both sides. So we can say that there is no pressure gradient. So the no trade winds are attracted towards the Australian subcontinent in the Indonesia and then the India. Or we can say that the trade winds become weaker and they pick up less moisture. So trade winds, we know that trade winds are very crucial to deliver monsoonal rains. So this is the condition when there is an El Nino effect. Now El Nino increases the rainfall in Peru and Ecuador, but it brings drought conditions in South Australia. It increases temperature in the North Australian deserts. It brings hurricanes and typhoons in the Pacific Ocean, and as a result, it leads into inflation in the economy of any country. So, when there is El Nino condition, we can say that there is an downwelling current, or there is a warm current in the near the coastline of as the temperature of the Pacific Ocean increases, there is a warm current. So, and on the both sides, here and on the side coastline of the Australian continent, there are warm currents. Means there is no pressure difference. So there are less number of trade winds that move from the Eastern Pacific Ocean to the Western Pacific Ocean, and they pick up winds. So since these trade winds do not pick up moisture, they will not bring rainfall to the Australian subcontinent as well as the Southeast Asian nations like Indonesia, Thailand, Cambodia, Myanmar, and India. And as a result of deficit rainfall, it will lead to the inflation in the economy because of the rise in the prices of the vegetables and fruits. And many more problems will occur, such as water crisis, drought conditions, and this will directly impact the people of the country. So this is the concept of El Nino phenomenon. Thank you for watching.